Hi, and welcome to Tiger Art. Today we'll be looking at things that were made in Africa. Africa is a continent, just like North America where we live. On the map of the world, you can see North America where the United States of America is, and obviously Pennsylvania and Erie, Pennsylvania. We know where all that stuff is. Down below us, our neighbors to the south, is what's called South America. If we go across the ocean to the other side, we'll have continents like Europe and Africa would be the first ones that we hit. Africa is down south below Europe on the map. If you were to go walking around outside in Africa, you may see some things that are very different from what you would see here. There are animals that live there, like lions and zebras and giraffes and elephants, that do not live outside in the wild around where we live. Think of like the movie The Lion King is set in Africa. So all the animals and the scenery there is kind of like some of the places in Africa. Well, there are people that live there too. And the people that live there, some of them are very, very skilled artists. And their style of art might be very different from our style of art. And the things that they wear could be very different from the things that we wear. Like, I may wear a shirt with a collar like this, because that is what I buy at the store, that's what they sell, that's what people wear in the United States. In Africa, maybe they don't wear it that as much. Traditionally, they have their own crafts and art and styles that may be different, and that's cool. That's something that we should celebrate. That's something that we should learn about, where people come from and what about their culture gives them their identity and who they are. So you may see things that look like this. This is an African necklace. Now, I've seen many people wearing necklaces around the United States, and it's usually something thin, maybe gold or silver, may have jewels on it or something. This is what an African necklace might look like. It's handmade. I also noticed that it is wide. It's very big. It would cover almost out to the shoulder. You can see on this mannequin here. What else do we notice about it? Notice that it's kind of flat. I notice that it's made of beads, and those beads are arranged into what we would call patterns. So it has patterns, it's wide, flat, it's got beads. It looks very nice. It looks like it was quality handmade by somebody who has a lot of experience and is a skilled craftsman. Here's another African necklace. When I look at this one, I notice that there are patterns in it, yes, but if you look carefully at the inside row of beads, we can see a repeating pattern that happens in a sequence. That sequence is black, black, red, black, black, red, black, black, red. That's a pattern. A pattern is something that repeats the same way every time. So by creating that pattern, the artist that made this necklace has made a nice looking rhythm through the middle of this. It's kind of like a repeating thing, you know, it's like a drum beat. First thing I notice about this one is that it's really big. I mean, that would cover almost all the way out to the shoulder. It's got repeating patterns. I can see repeating patterns of black and white. I can also see repeating patterns of other colors throughout, but it's got a lot of beads in this necklace. This would take quite some time and a lot of expertise to make something like this. Here's another beautiful African necklace. This one has some repeating patterns that we can see of black and white. We can also see some of the colors. There's like a orangish red kind of color in there that repeats in sequence, but it's made of beads, it's wide, it goes over the shoulder, and it looks very nice. This person is wearing several African necklaces all at the same time, and you can see that each one has a different feel to it. So there may be, the one on top has many layers of orange that makes a bigger shape. Some of the ones underneath have the colors repeating more quickly through the rhythm in the pattern, so that it's more broken up. There's not such a big wide space of all one color, but each one is unique, and you can tell that they're handmade, but they're handmade well. They weren't made by a machine, but they look like maybe they could have been, because they're so precise, they're so good. So what could we do with this? How could we use our knowledge of African necklaces and our inspiration to make something? How could we make something like this? Well, I'm not gonna have you string hundreds and thousands of beads together into patterns, because we don't have the time or the experience needed to do something like that. That's not very practical for our class. What we could use is something flat and round. If we could find something flat and round, something that you could cut, something that you could paint, something that you could glue on. If you guessed a paper plate, you're correct. That's exactly what we're gonna use. These are African paper plate necklaces, not made in Africa, but made by students in the United States of America, where we live, inspired by their study of Africa and their crafts. That's exactly what we're going to do. Before we get started on this, I wanted to do a brief review of patterns and how we label patterns. So there are different kinds of patterns. Depends on what you're talking about is repeating, but it needs to have something that repeats the same way every time. If it doesn't do that, there's a break in the pattern and it's no longer really a perfect pattern, because we don't know what would come next. In a perfect pattern, we always know what comes next as long as we can recognize the pattern. Let's talk about a few of them. We usually label them with letters like A and B. So whatever comes first, we assign it the letter A. Whatever comes second, we assign it the letter B. If there is something third, we would assign it the letter C. And if there's anything beyond that, we just keep going down the alphabet. So you could be talking about colors, you could be talking about shapes, but let's take a basic like stripe pattern, okay? It's gonna be black and white. We're gonna say that since black goes first, we're going to say that it is the A color. So A would be first, and that is black. White would be second, and that is B. The third thing is black, and we already gave that a letter, so we don't call it C, we actually call it A again, because once we call it A, it's always A. White would come next, and that would be B. So if you were to go through this, it would go A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B. If I were to ask you what kind of pattern is that, you would tell me just one piece of it, just what is the thing that repeats, and that is A, B. So this is an A, B pattern. We are going to be using an AB pattern for this necklace. We're going to be doing some cutting and some coloring on it today. To make this African plate necklace, you will need a paper plate. You will also need some scissors. You're going to start by cutting out that circle that's going around the center. So you'll start by making a cut that goes from the outside to that circle. Then you're going to cut right along it. This part can be discarded. This is the shape of your necklace. It should be going up like this, not down like that. Then you will need two colors of paint and a paintbrush. In your art kit, I've given you a paintbrush inside of your watercolors. I also gave you a paintbrush in your previous art kit that you should still have. Either one of those will work. This one might be a bit bigger and take less time. Pick two colors of paint. Doesn't matter what they are, just pick two colors. So I've chosen these two colors. You need to figure out which one is lighter. No matter what, your two colors, one of them is going to be the lighter one. If yellow's one of them, it's definitely it. You always want to do that first. So keep the other one closed and off to the side. You'll open the lighter color first. You don't want to go back and forth between the colors, because you're going to get all these mixed up and mixed together, and we are going to need this paint again. So I'm going to do all of my light color first. See how I have a big piece of paper on the table to protect the paint from getting all over the table? You should do that too. Get a large piece of paper or a newspaper or something. Start right here by painting a stripe. Then you're going to skip some space and paint another stripe. Skip some more space and paint another stripe. Okay, when you're done, you will need to clean out this brush. You should have a water cup from before. If not, you can get any old cup that you don't care about. Just make sure you're not using the nicest one that you got in your house. Get yourself in trouble. So now the good thing about this is that light color is not going to really mix this up at all. So if I accidentally get some of this yellow into this orange, the orange cup is still going to be fine. Now the backwards way of saying that would be if you get the orange into this yellow cup is going to be completely destroyed and you'll never get it to look yellow again. It's always going to look orange. That's why we start with the lighter color. So now with the clean brush, I'm going to go through and I'm going to paint those spots that I skipped with the darker color. This makes an A-B pattern. The A is the yellow and the B is the orange. You may pick two different colors and your A-B would be different. When you are done, you need to find a safe place to put this plate. You should clean out your paintbrush because we're definitely going to need that again and you don't want it to go to waste. So clean it out real good in the water, dry it off, never leave it in the cup, always take it out and leave it laying flat or up like this. Please do not throw any of these things away because you will need them. You need to put the caps back on your paint, make sure they snap tight. For today, you can take a picture and submit.